presenting to you our first guest speaker for Evolution Next. He's an advocate, he's an active politician, and someone who resonates with our ideology of empowering the youth with the knowledge of diplomacy and power of speech. Presenting to you, Mr. Niranjan Daukare. Right, so we have Sir here.
Yes, kind of.
Right. Sir, am I audible to you?
Yes.
Sir, am I audible to you?
Yeah.
Right, sir. So I was just discussing with them how we are more than happy to have you here with us, sharing your experience and knowledge about diplomacy and power of speech. So we are more than humbled and honored to have you with us. Over to you, sir.
First of all, namaste to all of you. And I congratulate you all because it is a very great initiative to get the youngsters on this platform. And on this platform, we are discussing more about civics, like what is the main work of people like us in the system and why you should, as a youngster, be more interested or more keen to know about what is happening overall in the society, in your state, in your city, in your nation. Because all these things affect your life also. Whatever decision is being taken in your city by your municipal corporation or by your cooperators, that affects your life. May it be in regards to the property tax, may it be in regards to the water tax. Then you say, "What? How will it affect my life, whatever the property tax may be?" So whenever a property tax is raised, it affects the economy of your house because that tax is charged to your home. And in that case, the economy that your mother or your father decides for your home, it affects the whole system of your home. Similarly, when a decision is made in legislative assembly or in a Vidhan Sabha in regards to anything which affects your city, that also indirectly affects your home. Simultaneously, any decision made in Lok Sabha in regards to income tax, that also affects your individual life. So we need to be aware of what is going on in the society and how all these things can affect our life. We have to have the knowledge of current affairs. We need to have the knowledge of general knowledge. So in that regards, we need to read newspapers. Now with the period of Corona, you all know that we, even at your homes, it must be a situation that newspapers which used to come at home, we are more on e-papers now. So I'll request you guys that you should read more of e-newspapers and come to know what is happening nationally and internationally. Because any international news has an impact on your country also, in our country also. And in that case, that has a domino effect throughout the whole situation. Like I said, any decision taken on a national front has an effect on the state. Any decision taken on the state front has an effect on your city level. And any decision on the city level affects your life. And there are many decisions that are taken on central level, which can affect directly to you. And that is why we need to know all these things. What happens in Lok Sabha? How do a Lok Sabha member work? How do a member of Legislative Assembly work? Usually when we see that their work is very simple. They give speeches, they meet people. But the contribution, the time, and the efforts that is spent throughout the work that has been done in the society is a huge amount of work that we all as a people's representative have to work through. We have to be available, like in the COVID period currently, we have to be available throughout 24 hours to the people, because any medical emergency can come up or any emergency in regards to the situation may crop up. And in that case, as a people's representative, it is our duty to be available to people throughout. During the current COVID situation, in the last second wave, if you could see, there was a very grave situation of people not getting beds, people not getting oxygen. And at that time, the first thing that you make a call to is the person who you know is a nearby local representative who can help you in that case. And so we have to be on toes currently throughout in such a situation, even during floods, even during drought, even during cyclone period. We have to be available to the people, which is our responsibility, which is our duty. And most of the time, when we have to work throughout, there's more of chance and it is always happening that there is less of a family time and more of a social time that you have to be, because then in that case, the definition of family changes. Rather than your mother, father, wife and kids, the family definition goes to the society. When we look at the society, we look society as a family part, and hence most of the time is contributed towards the society. When we make a policy, when we make any decision in regards to the state, we have to look to it that how many people are getting affected by it positively and negatively. Because any decision that is made becomes a law, and that law has to be abided by the citizens. And hence, the law has to be in such a manner that it won't be troublesome to the people. It shouldn't be bothersome to the people. People's life should be made more comfortable with that implementation of law. And hence, many laws are amended or many laws are created for such things. I'm sure that most of you must be at times must be feeling ki itna sab knowledge humko kyun chahiye, kyun ye policy decision ho raha hai. Yeah, for example, jo yesterday, three days ago, there was a situation between Twitter and our Central Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad. So how does these things affect you? But the situation that Ravi Shankar Prasad ji had to go through, or whatever happened, might be happening to you also. The similar situation was faced by other MP also. So these things you have to understand, and you have to have the knowledge to grow in all aspects of your life. I'm sure there is a lot of knowledge that has to be imparted and that needs to be given. And hence there are many courses which are being created for that. There are many IAS courses which have to be learned, which will help you to understand more of civics and how a municipal corporation works, how a corporator in that municipal corporation works, how a MLA works, how the Vidhan Sabha or the Assembly works, and how a member of parliament. Now, we have two types of member of parliament. One is from the Rajya Sabha and one is from the Lok Sabha. So member from Rajya Sabha is being nominated by the government or by the President of India. And a member of Lok Sabha is elected directly by the people. Similarly, in the assembly, we have two members. That is a member of Legislative Assembly and a member of Legislative Council. The member of Legislative Council may either be a graduate representative, he may be a teacher's representative, he may be from the number of corporators or local representatives that you elect. And there is also a category where the governor nominates a council member. And during when we speak about corporation, the corporation also has two categories. One is a nominated corporator and one is the elected corporators. All these people have to look into making policy decisions, which surely affects your life. I'm sure this knowledge that I am giving is useful to you. May I ask for any questions if there are any?
Absolutely, sir. I am pretty sure, you know, we have just received knowledge about what happens behind the scenes of whatever comes out to us during news, whenever we watch news. There are so many things that we do not know. How is this taking place? NMC workers, so many people out there. So I'm pretty sure all these students, they've discussed topics like Niti Aayog. They're very curious and understanding a few more things. So if anyone has any other questions to whatever sir has just shared with us, please feel free to unmute yourself and ask.
Shreya sir, can I go first?
Absolutely, Dheer.
Okay. Hello, Mr. Davkade sir. Sir, my name is Dheer Kulkarni. I'm a big fan of Indian politics, and I'm just really fascinated by, you know, the entire concept of it. My only question to you right now is that, you know, in India currently, there are many young people who are getting involved into politics. You know, so my question to you would be that what is that one quality, like one supreme or that one main quality that every young man and every young woman must have to, you know, sustain in Indian politics and, you know, make a change?
Dheer, very good question. And to sustain in politics, you need to have a lot of patience and you have to be ready to do a lot of hard work because people see many things coming it in an easy way. But there is a lot of struggle that we have to do throughout the political this thing. And like I said, you have to contribute more of your time to the society rather than your family. So you have to sacrifice your personal family life to be more with the society, because there are many situations. Like for a police person, it is a situation in regards to law and order where he is more concerned with. Administration is more concerned with administrative decision. But a politician, or to work in politics, you have to touch every aspect of life. You have to see to it that an industrialist who is running a small unit, a small scale unit in your constituency, it is running smooth because it is giving employment to many people. So you have to look into that. Then there are situations where there is a small issue like water connection. You even have to look into that. Or there may be a situation where people want some rickshaw stand in nearby their society. Or some people have an issue. The most important part is patience, taking good decision, and contributing more of your time.
Thank you so much, sir. It really helped me a lot.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
If there are any other questions, please feel free
to unmute
yourself.
Excuse me? I want to...
Delegate. One by one. One by one delegate, of course.
Can I say?
Absolutely. Go ahead, delegate.
First of all, I'm very much inspired by you. And I want to ask that question that what struggle did you face to become a politician?
There are a lot of struggles that we have to face. Like I said previously, that I'll repeat again, that you have your family life suffers a lot. And because the concept of family changes, the society in itself, the whole society in itself is your family. And that is why more of your time is contributed towards the society. And the most struggling part is with the administration, actually, because if you see our system from the British time is more of an administrative driven system. And we have to be thankful to Baba Saheb Ambedkar, because with the constitution, he has placed the local representatives or the MLAs or MPs in such a manner that every 5 years, the people have the right to change those people. So we have to fight throughout the period with the administrative system to ensure the people have their rights in place.
Thank you. So this will help me a lot in future to become a politician.
Thank you. I'm happy that you are interested in being a politician.
Yes, sir.
On that note, sir, I'm pretty sure a lot of students have questions, but of course we cannot ask all of them to entertain. But so there's one question that I would like to ask you. As a politician,
yeah,
as taking politics as a career, as, you know, moving forward with it, there's a lot of negative criticism that comes on. So how, as a person, how do you cope up with that? How do you, you know, tell yourself, no, this is still what I'm going to do, no matter what people say? Because nowadays people are affected about others' opinion. They're really, really affected about what others think about them. So they don't try to fight back. They don't try to prove themselves right. But as a politician, there are times wherein you receive good criticism, there's times wherein you receive negative criticism. So how do you deal with that?
See, frankly speaking, this profession in itself is filled with negativity, because most of the time many times people come with their problems, and you are in a problem-solving situation. It's more like a doctor's profession. They come with the problems and you have to give them solutions. Second aspect is that the opposition party is always trying to cut you down to ensure that your popularity in the people don't grow. But we have to keep our focus clear. It's more like a work of, like, if you see, if I give an example, it's more like Arjuna having his focus on the eye of the fish. So you have to keep your inner soul very clear that whatever you're doing it for the people. And when you're doing it for the people, whatever all the negativity comes around you, it will give you a strong positivity when the work is executed. Your work speaks for you.
Absolutely, sir. Having a straight mindset, just achieving your goal. And that is, I think, some great knowledge for today's youth you've shared with us today. We are truly inspired by all of your words, sir. Thanks a lot for joining us over here today. Really, really meant a lot for us. Thanks a lot,
sir. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir.
And I'm really very happy that youngsters like you have such an this platform to discuss all these ideas, and great work. Congratulations.
Thanks a lot, sir. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.